The chef or cook is the secret ingredient in any dish, and someone who's passionate about their cooking will always add a big dollop of meraki. It's not an approach that lends itself to fast food, as you'll see when we join Mary Chetty as she prepares to treat her guests to an Indian fine dining experience.
If there's a cardinal rule for throwing a dinner party, it's that nothing must be done in a hurry. And Mary made sure that there was ample time for every detail to be taken care of. This also entailed timing the preparations so that the food would be at its best when her guests arrived. And Karishma offered to assist in the kitchen.
I'm back in the kitchen with the wonderful Mary Chetty. She's invited me to a very special dinner later tonight, and I cannot wait to find out what's on the menu. What are you going to show me how to prepare today?
So we're going to start off with making our meatballs in chutney, and then I'm also going to show you how I do a butter chicken.
Lovely. What's first?
So here I've got some lean mince. To that I'll add some chopped onion, then some chopped coriander. This is fresh from our garden. Then some chopped chives. Then I move on to the wet ingredients. Put some nice crushed chili in there and a teaspoonful of ginger and garlic paste. Then we move on to the dry ingredients and we add some chili powder, some turmeric. This is crushed cumin. I roast and grind these seeds. Then the coriander seed that's ground as well, and some fennel seeds, which is som. And I do believe that fresh spices add such a beautiful flavor to a good curry. And then we add some salt. I'm now going to give it a good mix. And when it's all coming together, I put the spoon down and I use my hands and I go in and really get all the spices worked into the meat. And then we'll be ready to just make them into our little meatballs. Just grab a bit of the mixture and then it goes onto the tray that goes into the oven. When you've got the meat in your hand, try and pull your fingers towards your thumb, and that would make all the meat come together very nicely and give you a nice round meatball.
That's a great tip to do it with one hand.
So Karishma, I'm gonna now put these meatballs into the oven at 170 degrees for 15 to 20 minutes. Whilst the meatballs are in the oven, I'm gonna start with the chutney. So first let's turn the gas on and then get some oil into the pan. Next goes in the onion, Karishma, and I also add in a cinnamon stick just to bring out the flavor of the oil. So in goes in the chili, and then the ginger and garlic paste. Then I put in some crushed cumin and some turmeric and just a bit of chili for the color. So now we throw in the tomatoes, and the trick is that you take the skin off so that you have a nice smooth chutney when it's done. So there we go, the chutney's on the go. Just want to add some salt. I'm now going to add in the tomato paste, and then we'll be ready to add in the meatballs. Karishma, won't you help me please?
Of course.
Spoon those meatballs in. Lovely. So while that's simmering, let's get onto the butter chicken. We're going to add some butter ghee and some butter. Turn up the heat, let that melt a bit. Now in goes the chicken. It's got to be on high heat because I just want to seal the chicken. Have a look. This is now ready to be taken off. It's just been fried off. Won't you please pass me that dish? We'll take that off. Okay. So we'll take the chicken out. Okay, so please put that down for me, Karishma. I add a little bit more butter ghee into the pan and then more butter. And to that, I'll add in my chopped onion. Give that a bit of a stir and let it simmer until the onions are nice golden brown. And into that, I'm gonna add in a cinnamon stick. In goes the cumin. To that, we add in the turmeric. Now I add in the garlic and ginger paste, and then goes in the chili. To that I'm going to add in the tomato and give that all a nice stir and let it now simmer so that it cooks up very nicely to a soft pulp. Okay, so let's have a look, Karishma. This is now ready and done. So now I'm just going to add the finishing touches. So to this I'm going to add tomato paste, some coconut cream, and then in goes the fresh cream. Let's just make sure that it's all infused and comes to a nice boil. Now, please will you pass me the chicken?
go.
In that goes. So let's stir all that in, and we can now put the lid on and let it simmer for another 10 minutes.
Mary, your table looks exquisite. Could you take me through the table setting?
I've gone for the jewel tones, as you can see. Bright flowers to just bring in our Indian culture. And on the table, I've used as a tablecloth a sari that my mom gave me, that she brought back from Mumbai.
I'm so excited for tonight, and I know guests are going to be arriving really soon, so I think you and I need to go and get ready.
Yes, very much so.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Any excuse to wear a sari, and it definitely works for tonight's Bollywood theme. The guests have arrived, so I'm going to go and mingle. Cyril, hi, how are you?
Can I introduce you to Yati?
Hi, Yati, so lovely to meet you.
Lovely to meet you.
And this is Rebecca.
Rebecca, lovely to
lovely
meet you.
Lovely to meet you, Karishma.
So lovely to meet you.
Really nice meeting you.
Who is the biggest Indian food fan here tonight?
Nobody can beat me.
We're going to be the Indian food choir tonight, basically. Just,
really?
Just cheering.
What do you love about Indian food?
Like the options of the spiciness.
How spicy do you like it?
Not to the Indian level hot, but mild. Hot.
So no sweat and tears?
Indian mild. Because it's a different kind of mild.
A very warm welcome to you. Thank you for coming and enjoy.
Thanks for having us. This looks absolutely beautiful.
So Karishma, you know traditionally that we eat in Indian homes with our hands. So it's a good idea to have them washed beforehand. In the water, there's rose water put in with some petals in that the guests are going to dip their hands into, and then we rinse off with more rose water and petals. Dip your hands into the water. How does that feel?
Lovely, and it smells beautiful too.
Good. Then we rinse off. Help yourself to the towel.
With a bit of coriander.
Got some yogurt for you.
Thank you so much.
Delicious.
While the guests enjoyed the appetizers, Mary and her helpers were hard at work in the kitchen, plating the main course. And with delicious butter chicken on the menu, rotis were essential to scoop and soak up every delectable morsel. When everyone was seated and served, it was time to relax, enjoy the meal and the company, and compliment the cooks.